our fellow citizens, our way of life, our very freedom came under attack in a series of deliberate and deadly terrorist acts.
I can hear you! I can hear you, the rest of the world hears you, and the people... And the people who knocked these buildings down will hear all of us soon.
This means war.
My understanding or impression of the Patriot Act is that it was a legislation that was passed, a law that was passed and signed by President Bush in response to 9/11. It allowed the federal government to really tap in better to our communication systems, to understand our banking systems, to be able to trace and find, apprehend, and prosecute people who might be involved in terrorism either within or outside of the United States.
Patriot Act, I would say it is a collection of laws ostensibly created to tweak existing laws or change and modify substantially existing laws in many different aspects of law enforcement, intelligence gathering, different agencies of government. It modified, you know, many, many things.
For me, civil liberties are really what you find in the Bill of Rights. For me, this fact that we have our civil liberties in the United States is what makes the United States so great. We have the right to free speech. We have the right to assemble. We have these freedoms that are inherent in our Constitution and are there for everyone to enjoy. So in my opinion, my civil liberties that are important to me are the ones that are protected in the Bill of Rights.
Civil liberties are they are codified or, you know, set forth in the first 10 amendments to our Constitution, and it's, so as a lawyer, that's what I think about. But as a citizen, what we think about civil liberties are those aspects of the Constitution, the protections that we have that essentially make us Americans, give us the set of rights and privileges that we have as Americans.
Follow directions, you'll live through this.
How are you seeing us right now?
Disobey.
What did she say?
And you die.
Somebody's hacking into the power grid. Traffic cams.
The lights are all turning green.
You got a theory?
I don't believe they're abusing anything. Obviously, anything that is law-abiding, they follow the law. There are a lot of myths out there. But I do believe that the authorities and the people that use the act are using it in the best interest of the United States.
I don't. I am a person who believes that, first of all, anything that's done under the Patriot Act, and there are examples under the Patriot Act where you can do warrantless searches and seizures of information. And that sounds a little scary on its face. But I know that the government, should they attempt to use that against someone, still enjoys the protections of due process. So if the federal government wants to prosecute you for information they obtained with a warrant that a judge hasn't signed, you, through your due process rights, have the opportunity to challenge that. And a judge gets to hear that case. And if something was done improperly, that's what the judge is there to protect. So our entire system of justice really assures that even though the Patriot Act has really broadened the power of the federal government, that there's always going to be a check and a balance to make sure that people are being treated fairly ultimately, because that information can't be used against you unless it was lawfully obtained.
Do you believe the government is abusing the Patriot Act?
I definitely do. Most of the Patriot Act was designed around keeping an eye on American people, and it's very rare that American people are causing terrorism to our own country.
Well, you know, that's a very difficult question, and the reason why is oftentimes the safety that we have is because people use information to make sure they protect us. So that's the weight that you have, is whether you want to weigh that being more important than them actually taking the information that you have that you consider personal and using that in a way that you might not find to be acceptable.
I have here a report from the LATimes.com that says that FBI intelligence investigations have compromised the civil liberties of American citizens far more frequently to a greater extent than was previously assumed.
Yeah, go ahead. Okay. All right.
Guys, I'm sorry.
The Patriot Act is a destructive undermining of the Constitution. We started this Congress off with a discussion about reading the Constitution. Many of us carry constitutions with us in our pocket. How about today we take a stand for the Constitution to say that all Americans should be free from unreasonable search and seizure?
The purpose of the Patriot Act is to keep suspected terrorists under surveillance in an attempt to prevent another attack on our country like we suffered on September 11th, 2001. I believe that it has been successful, and I support its extension.
This, to me, has been, especially since 9/11, a classical example of sacrificing liberty for safety and security.
Listen, Americans' present condition needs serious recognition, because if there is no repentance, then there will be no redemption, and that sentence is more serious than Vietnam, the atom bomb, and Saddam, and Minister Farrakhan. What's going on? What's a priority to you? By what authority do we do? The majority have not a clue. Black people majored in curses, search the chapters, check the verses, recapture land, remove the mark from off our hands. So we can stand in agreement with Jesus Christ's command. Everything else is damn, let them with ears understand that. I had a vision, I was falling in indecision, appalling, calling religion some program on television. Oh, say, can't you see? Pledge allegiance with your fascist flags flying free. Fake patriotic mislead. I had a vision, I was falling in indecision, appalling, calling religion some program on television.